It's AumSum time!
Why are there 7 days in a week? Duh, cause there are 7 nights in a week. No, the reason goes all the way back to ancient Babylonians. On studying the moon cycle, Babylonians observed that, approximately every 7 days, the moon changed its phase, coining the idea of a 7-day week. Also, 7 was considered a mystical number, associated with the 7 heavenly bodies, the moon, sun, and the 5 discovered planets. Number 7 was also very holy to the Jews, who kept the 7th day for rest and worship. Ultimately, in 321 AD, a Roman emperor named Constantine made it official. Romans named the days after their gods, like Saturday came from Saturn, the Roman god. However, over time, names of the remaining days were mostly adapted from Norse gods, that is. Thursday came from Thor, Friday from Freya, etc. Ultimately, the 7-day week was standardized and adopted worldwide. Can you hear colors or see sounds?
No, but I can eat cakes and watch a movie at the same time.
Alright, now listen. There's a real condition called synesthesia in which the stimulation of one sense triggers an automatic, involuntary experience in another sense. So, when synesthetes hear different tones, they may see different colors. Oh. Or when they see or think certain words, they may experience taste of food items. Some of them may even associate letters, numbers, or words with colors. We don't actually know why this happens, but researchers think that when we are born, we have more connections between the sensory areas of the brain. However, as we mature, most of the connections are blocked or pruned so that we experience the senses separately. But in some people, these connections don't get pruned efficiently, so they may experience 2 or more senses simultaneously. Is radiation harmful?
Yes, dude! It is very, very harmful!
No, not every radiation is harmful. Radiation is basically energy traveling as waves or particles. It can be classified as ionizing and non-ionizing radiation. Non-ionizing radiation includes visible light, infrared rays, microwaves, radio waves, etc. Non-ionizing radiation is generally not harmful. Now, ionizing radiation includes gamma rays, X-rays, radiation given off by radioactive elements, nuclear power plants, nuclear weapons, etc. Although we are daily exposed to low levels of ionizing radiation, it doesn't cause any harm. However, exposure to high levels of ionizing radiation in a short period of time can damage the DNA in our cells, causing cell dysfunction or even cell death. Also, sometimes when the damaged DNA tries to repair itself, there can be a change or mutation in the genes, leading to uncontrolled cell division and thus causing cancer. High levels of ionizing radiation can even turn water in our body into hydrogen peroxide, which is really toxic. Thus, the ionizing radiation can prove to be very harmful. Why do some people sweat more than others?
Because they like the smell of their sweat.
Oh, gross. No. Sweating or perspiration is a very essential process. Sweat absorbs heat from our body and evaporates, thus helping us regulate our body temperature. Now, during exceptional situations, such as on a hot day or while exercising, it is okay to sweat more than usual. But some people keep on sweating even under normal conditions. Such excessive sweating is the result of a condition called hyperhidrosis. In this condition, the sweat glands overreact and produce more sweat than necessary. Besides this, caffeine in coffee and nicotine in cigarettes also make us sweat more. In addition to this, men tend to sweat more than women.